To collect military artifacts is to own an actual piece of history. Militaria is very popular and covers a lot of categories. One of my favorites, uniforms. Of course, you'll find uniforms at places like this, the Texas Military Forces Museum. But we discovered a collection that you're going to have to see to believe. It wasn't in a museum, it was actually in somebody's home. Ken and Linda are retired Air Force. Their front door guarded by these two pilots. And on the other side, a very unique collection.
We bought a picture at an estate sale of a young Army nurse. And then we decided, well, we need to buy a uniform. And then we need to buy a mannequin to put it on. We have about 115 mannequins inside the house. And then we have three closets full of uniforms.
So where do you put over 100 clothed mannequins? Well, that's easy. Everywhere. With a focus on World War II, almost every room in the house is a winding road through the 1940s. While many military uniform collections focus on combat gear, theirs has a unique twist. They include a large number of items worn by women.
They played such a big part during World War II. Besides the nurses, women built airplanes, women worked on the trains, women did so many things while the gentlemen were at war. And so they played such a big part in the war, we wanted to include their uniforms. Somebody wore that uniform, and somebody wore it during the war. A Red Cross, maybe she worked with the nurses, she worked as a nurse in the VA hospitals, or worked with veterans when they came home who had been wounded. And so some of the uniforms still have a little bit of blood mark on them, you know, and it's like these are the things that they wore when they were fighting the war, or their contributions to the war.
Acquiring historic military uniforms, not to mention the cost of the display, can turn into an expensive endeavor.
I think the most valuable one in the collection is General Robbins' uniform. It was their ceremonial uniform, and a little bit hard to get, and we're working on getting the rest of it. And once we get it set up, it'll be worth pretty good money.
And while I was being shown around, I noticed something a little different, so I had to ask. Were people smaller back then?
Yes.
Now, what kind of advice would you give somebody who's just trying to get into this kind of collecting? What is one of the biggest challenges you face?
We got a lot of these on eBay, and so you just have to look at it carefully and do some research. A lot of times they don't call them the right stuff, and so you have to research it. Get a book on uniforms, women's uniforms or men's uniforms, and do some research yourself before you start spending $200 or $300 or $400 for a uniform. Because you want the most accurate uniform. For the Cadet Nurse Corps, there's a summer uniform and a winter uniform. The hat can be worn interchanged, but there is a summer uniform hat, and that makes it more valuable. When you go to a military show, you want to talk to the people and examine the product that you're buying. If you know somebody who sells uniforms, get them to look at it too. But you want to make sure that you're buying what you think you're buying.
Here's my question to you. Mm-hmm. If you could only grab 5 uniforms mm-hmm. and take them, which one of those uniforms would that be?
I would Army Nurse Corps uniform, one of the summer uniform for the Cadet Nurse Corps, the USO uniform, and the WASP uniform. And then just one of the ladies' dresses. They had to be in uniform 24/7, so when they socialized, they had a dress for them to wear. That's what they went out on their dates, or that's what they went out to go to a party or an event.
Is there a piece or a number of pieces that are on your wish list that you don't have that you're looking for?
Yes. Santiago blue WASP uniform. We have the flight suit. That was only used for about 11 months. But I'd like one of the Santiago blue that has the blue pants, the blue shirt, and it has the Ike jacket.
Dozens of uniforms, every piece of cloth, hat, button, or bar, a part of history. And for one Texas couple, a very personal collection honoring the brave men and women who have served our country. Please hit subscribe to enjoy more videos like this. Also, check out our website and Facebook page. Thanks for watching, and always remember, surround yourself with what you love.